Good evening, folks. Welcome to the Learn on the Go series. And in today's video, we will be taking a look at the combination lock, or the lock which has, you know, rotary disks with passwords. So let's go. We'll be opening this particular lock, and then we'll be taking a look at how it works and why it actually should be working. The password for this one is 2365. And basically what happens is, like, all of these aligned in this particular way, they make the passage of these groups possible through it. And if you rotate it, that's not going to be possible. You can take a look over here. See, if you rotate it, this is blocked, and that's why it won't really be moving inside and outside. So we'll be trying it open and taking a look. So there is a clip lock over here. Needs to be taken out. Not a simple one. So this is taken out. Now there is a stopper over here. Looks like this. We'll keep it this way. Now this is the first dial. You can take a look inside it. It has a recess over here for the key to pass. Take a look. If it's at this position, it will move. If it's at this position, it won't move. Likewise, the remaining barrels or the dials are arranged with a spring, this type of spring, to hold it in place. And the spring is so aligned that the passage is along the passage of the barrel or the passage of the dial itself. First, second, third, and fourth. So if you take a look at it, it basically consists of a spline stone to which this particular fits. And now, depending upon what the password is, your barrels would be locking it. And only if you are knowing the exact code where all of these recesses in these barrels, if they are aligned, then only it will be coming out. So that's how it works. Let's try to align them back. It didn't get damaged. We are doing a small video called the last sort of time, had a yesterday. So this was the video that I thought of doing it earlier, or I couldn't get time to do this one. Okay, so that's how it's arranged. And once all of them are put, you simply press the clip over here, and the system is complete. As simple as that. That's one of the most simplest lock that you would ever see. Basically, it's used, I used it for my Java motorcycle because it was not really having any proper kind of lock. And later, once I sold it off, I'm using the same for my cycle. So let's take a look. Right now it's free because all the recesses on the barrels are aligned. And once we push it in and rotate the barrels, say like jumble it up, now it would be docked. So that's how it works, folks. Let's make it work more. Now it's aligned, it's out. Now it's pretty simple machine or mechanism or a lock. Basically, this particular technology is not new. It dates back to 12th century AD, and there were you know, evidences of these kind of locks even before that. And it's kind of like a pretty old one, but nevertheless it's pretty useful. Now there is one more thing that we usually forget about combination locks, and once the password is, you know, it's released or a lot of people know about it, we simply prefer throwing it. But you don't really need to do that. What you actually have to do is, you have to open the clip over here, and then you have to reorder these barrels so that they could be different from what they were earlier, and then it would again be, you know, it would be giving you an, approximately 24 combinations, like if you are changing this one with the last one and things like that. So mathematically talking, if you have taken out all the barrels, then the first position could be filled by four types of barrels, the second position could be filled with three types of barrels, that is whatever is left, the third position could be filled by two types of barrels, and the last would be filled with one type of barrel. So total number of combination over here is 4 × 3 × 2. That gives you 24 combinations. So you actually have 23 more ways in case your password has been like way too popular with your peers or so. So that's how you can make it secure once it's once the security of this particular lock is compromised. So be it, folks. Stay tuned for more. Till the next time, have a good day. Build it, ride it.